And I represent the largest media organization in Belarus, the Belarus Today Publishing House. It is a media holding that unites the country's five largest newspapers, a radio station, and a network edition. And I would like to thank the organizers of this conference for the hospitality and the opportunity to tell such a wide and representative audience about the development of the media in Belarus and our role in promoting the BR initiative. First of all, I would like to note that Belarus is one of the first countries that not only supported the concept of the Silk Road, but also began its practical implementation in the country. The advantages of such cooperation are clearly demonstrated by the Great Stone Industrial Park, which has become a hub in the economic belt of the Silk Road. More than 40 residents from different countries have already registered in it, and it is not just a logistics hub, as some experts imagine. It is becoming an international high-tech cluster, a center for attracting investments in various fields. The main advantage of Belarus is its favorable geographical location. Furthermore, our country is the last stop on the Silk Road before the European Union, which gives Belarus a strategic role in the implementation of China's plans. Of course, the economy is the hub of the mega project, but the initiative should be considered more globally, because without cultural and humanitarian ties, any union is doomed to failure. Therefore, we believe that the media of the partner countries should also consolidate their efforts. Humanitarian cooperation is an important tool for strengthening mutual understanding between countries, and the principle of interaction between the mass media should be considered as support of the Belt and Road Initiative. Let me remind you that in October 2016, the first Silk Road Media Cooperation Forum was held in Nanjing, where the so-called Nanjing Consensus was adopted. It was at this meeting that the Silk Road Media Union was established in order to promote a variety of dialogues, exchanges of information products, and advanced technologies between the media of the countries located along the Belt and Road Initiative. At the same time, we believe it is necessary to more actively create a single information space within the framework of this project. The opportunities for interaction should be maximized, including by the use of the multilingual cloud platform for the preparation of news publications and exchange of news translations. Belarus is moving forward in this direction. In particular, last year, the Belarus Today Publishing House signed a partnership agreement with the Sinhua News Agency, the official news agency of Chinese government. Materials on both China and Belarus are published on a mutual basis. A special heading, Window to China, has been created on the website of our holding. You can also read about Belarus on the pages of the official printed edition of the Central Committee of the Chinese Communist Party Jinmin Jibao daily newspaper. In addition, this April, the Belarus Today Publishing House became a co-founder of the Belt and Road News Network. This is an important step in promoting Belarus in the project's information space. And now let me briefly tell you about Belarus' media market. There are 1,616 printed media, 273 electronic media, and 9 information agencies. Printed media in Belarus are mainly published in Belarusian and Russian. Also, there are editions in English, Polish, Ukrainian, and German, including the Minsk Times, a newspaper, part of Belarus Today Media Holding, which is published in English. It is a socio-political weekly edition which tells an English-speaking audience about the life of our country. I should say that in recent years, the segment of printed media of the Republic of Belarus has seen fundamental structural changes taking place. The establishment of the administration of the President of the Republic of Belarus, the Belarus Today Publishing House, is a large media holding which includes the SB Belarus Сегодня, Народная газета, Республика, Сельская газета, Знамя юности, and the Minsk Times newspaper. The publishing house also includes the radio station Alpha Radio and the Web TV and the SB.by portal. Here are some interesting statistics. The daily number of visitors to the sb.by portal is up to 200,000. The circulation of the printed edition is more than 400,000 copies in a country of just over 10 million people. There is no doubt that Belarus is now not only from the printed media. There are 9 news agencies in the country, 7 of them are private. There are also representative offices of Russian news agencies, TASS, Prime, and world leading agencies like Reuters, Associated Press, and Xinhua. There are also 174 radio programs and 102 television programs broadcast in Belarus. Yeah, yeah. The broadcasts of the radio station Belarus are designed for foreign audience interested in events in our country. It broadcasts in Belarusian, Russian, English, German, Polish, French, Spanish, and Chinese. The first and the only international satellite TV channel of Belarus, Belarus 24, works 24 hours a day for 27 million viewers over 100 countries. As you can see, the media market of Belarus is well developed and meets the need of quality content, including the implementations of the BR initiative. There is a tendency in the world for some founded media to slander investment partners in competition. In many media, you can read a great deal of skepticism about the appropriateness of China's initiative. But the implementations of the project in practice is the best counter-argument, and that is why the strengthening of cooperation between the media, the implementation of cultural exchanges, and the creation of a friendly and harmonious information space are the most important conditions for the Belt and Road Initiative implementation. And in conclusion, I would like to tell one ancient parable. One old man had 3 sons who couldn't get along. The old man wanted his sons to live in peace after his death. So he decided to teach them a lesson. One day the father called them and asked them to break a broom in half. First, the eldest son tried, but no matter how hard he tried, nothing worked. The same failures befell the middle and junior sons. Then the father untied the broom and asked each son to break a few straws. They easily coped, of course. Then the father said, "The same happens in life. If you are together, no one will be able to break you, and separately, as you are easy to beat as breaking a cup of straws." Thank you for your attention.